Hello viewers, welcome to CSS World. In this video, we are going to study Chemical Weapons Convention, that is CWC. There are various chemical weapons including sarin gas, sulfur mustard or mustard gas, and nitrogen mustard. Chemical weapons come under the notion of the weapons of mass destruction. Let's start this lecture now. First of all, introduction to Chemical Weapons Convention. Chemical Weapons Convention is an arms control treaty that outlaws the production, stockpiling, and use of chemical weapons. So this convention aims to eliminate an entire category of weapons of mass destruction by prohibiting the development, production, acquisitioning, stockpiling, retention, transfer, or use of chemical weapons by states parties. States parties in turn must take the steps necessary to enforce that prohibition in respect of persons within their jurisdiction. This convention was opened for signature on 30th January 1993 and entered into force on 29th April 1997. This convention has 192 state parties and one signatory, that is Israel. Keep in mind that four countries are not party to this convention. They include Israel, Egypt, North Korea, and South Sudan. Out of these four, Israel is signatory of this convention, but it did not ratify it, whereas other three countries neither signed it nor ratified it. Now, key points of CWC. Key points of Chemical Weapons Convention include prohibition of production and use of chemical weapons, which means that this convention completely bans the parties to produce or use chemical weapons. Second one is destruction of chemical weapons production facilities. Under this point, the Chemical Weapons Convention asks the parties to destroy the chemical weapons production facility also, so that the parties may not ever be able to produce these weapons after becoming party to this convention. Third one, destruction of all chemical weapons. This convention obligates the parties to destroy all the already existing chemical weapons. Fourth one, assistance between state parties and the OPCW in the case of use of chemical weapons. OPCW stands for Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. It is basically an elaborate mechanism to ensure compliance with convention. OPCW also inspects production of chemicals which might be converted to chemical weapons. Fifth one, international cooperation in the peaceful use of chemistry in relevant areas. So under this convention, the peaceful use of chemistry is not only allowed, but it also promotes cooperation in this regard. Now the compliance system. CWC has its own mechanism to ensure compliance with the convention, which is the distinctive mark of this convention. It is administered by a special international organization, namely the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, that is OPCW, that we have already discussed above. It consists of a number of different elements, including routine verification of the destruction which are required, routine verification of the non-diversion of certain chemicals from peaceful to military purposes, inspections in case of doubt about compliance, reactions to non-compliance, national measures of implementation, clarifications, and challenge inspections. If a state party has doubt about compliance by any other state party, it may ask for clarification. It may also request an on-site challenge inspection of the location where the doubtful activities allegedly taken place. This is a necessary complement to the routine verification procedures, which are all limited to declared facilities. Activities taking place outside these declared facilities are not covered by routine inspection. The challenge inspection is necessary to fill this possible gap in the monitoring system. enforcement and settlement of disputes. If inspections reveal non-compliance, the secretariat brings the case before the OPCW Executive Council or even the Conference of States Parties. Among the measures which can be taken are such sanctions as the suspension of membership rights. The Executive Council or the Conference may also bring the case before the United Nations. The Security Council may then decide to take enforcement action according to Chapter 7 of the Charter of the United Nations. In addition to this enforcement system, the CWC provides for a traditional interstate dispute settlement procedure also. So CWC is well known for its strict compliance system, which really helps in maintaining chemical weapons free world. Now we will see that what were the historical perspectives which led world towards the Chemical Weapons Convention. The use of chemical weapons during the First World War generated a great shock in public opinion and soon triggered initiatives to ban these weapons, both their use and later their possession. These efforts started with 1919 Paris Peace Treaties, which prohibited the possession of such weapons by the states which had lost the war. A prohibition of the use of these weapons based on the language of Paris Peace Treaties was first stipulated in the Treaty for the Limitation of Naval Armament adopted by the Conference on the Limitation of Armament held in Washington in 1922 and then in the 1925 Protocol for the Prohibition of the Use of Poisonous Gases During War, which is Geneva Protocol, which have been covered in another lecture, the link of which is available in the description. It banned bacteriological methods of warfare. The Geneva Protocol constituted a major breakthrough as it was widely ratified, although it was slow in finally winning real universal participation. Chemical weapons were also an important part of the arms control negotiations conducted under the League of Nations. After the Second World War, it was again the use of chemical weapons, namely the use of tear gas and herbicides by the United States in the Vietnam War, which triggered new attempts to strengthen their ban. The United Nations General Assembly adopted resolutions to this effect, declaring the content of the Geneva Protocol to be part of customary international law and at the same time inviting states to adhere to protocol. A ban on possession of such weapons became part of the arms control negotiations conducted under the United Nations. It was possible to separate the question of biological weapons, which became the object of a special treaty in 1972. Yet the negotiations on chemical weapons lasted for more than 20 years, the major stumbling block being a compliance system which had to be effective on the one hand but not too intrusive on the other. The final success of these negotiations was the adoption of the Chemical Weapons Convention in 1992, which entered into force in 1997. This was all from today's lecture. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.